Dear students, welcome back to Lakshya Amrit Nilayam classes. Today we will discuss about electromagnetic induction. Previous topic, electromagnetism. A current carrying conductor that produces magnetic field around it, that we have discussed in previous class, electromagnetism. Now, electromagnetic induction. Due to the change in magnetic flux linked with the coil, an EMF will be produced in that coil. This phenomenon of generation of that induced EMF due to the change in magnetic flux, that is known as electromagnetic induction. When a moving conductor that cuts the magnetic flux, then also EMF will be produced within This phenomenon itself is known as electromagnetic induction. Due to the change in magnetic flux, and mari ee chapter anta kuda flux change in magnetic flux gurinchi discuss chestam kabatti, now that magnetic flux phi, that is equal to B bar dot A bar. Magnetic flux linked with the coil, that is equal to B bar dot A bar, which is equal to A B cos theta. Suppose if the coil consists of n number of turns, then the total flux linked, that is NAB into cos theta. Now, where theta is the angle between A bar and B bar, what is the direction of A bar? Normal to the plane of the coil. Normal to the plane of the coil, that represents the area vector. Okay, now that unit for that magnetic flux, flux unit, MKS unit, that is Weber. Whereas in CCS unit, that is Maxwell. One Weber, that is equal to 10 to the power of 8 Maxwell. Now, what will be the dimension formula for that magnetic flux? Sorry, flux phi, that is equal to B into A unto norm. You know that F is equal to MB cavity, B place though F by M rasputam. And M is the pole strength, ampere meter. Sorry, the force P. Dimensional formula M L T minus 2 by force strength M ampere meter, meter and L into A and L square. So dimensional formula for that magnetic flux, that is M L square T minus 2 A minus 1. That will be the dimensional formula for magnetic flux phi. Now this electromagnetic induction that was first observed by Faraday, due to the relative motion between two magnets or between two coils or between a coil and a magnet, an EMF will be induced. This was first observed by Faraday. Due to the relative motion between the coil and magnet, an EMF will be induced within the coil. Consider this is a circular coil which is connected to a galvanometer which determines the strength and direction of current flow. Now, then a bar magnet with its north pole facing the coil, that is moved towards the coil, the magnetic flux linked with that coil increases. Due to the change in flux, an EMF will be induced and the galvanometer shows reflection in one particular direction. If the same magnet that was moved away, now the flux linked with the coil gradually decreases. Due to the decrease in flux, once again EMF will be produced within that coil, but that induced current that will be opposite to the previous direction. And the flux increase, the that EMF and induced current produced in one direction. If the same magnet that was moved away, now the flux is decreasing as that magnet is moving away. Due to the decrease in magnetic flux, decrease flux will change. As long as there is change in flux, EMF will be produced and the galvanometer shows deflection. Suppose if that magnet is rotated about its axis at the same position, then there is no change in magnetic flux linked with the coil and the galvanometer shows doesn't show any deflection, or the galvanometer shows zero deflection. This was first observed by Faraday. Now, that amount of that induced current and EMF produced in the coil, that depends upon the relative motion. When the magnet is moved quickly, more EMF will be produced. When that is moved slowly, towards or away, then the induced EMF and induced current in that galvanometer, that will be less. Next. Faraday, after conducting several experiments, he formulated two fundamental laws regarding that induced EMF and induced current. Electromagnetic induction. Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. We have two laws. Whenever there is change in magnetic flux linked with the coil, an EMF will be induced in the coil, and that induced EMF lasts as long as there is change in magnetic flux linked with the coil. That was first law, Faraday's first law. Whenever there is change in magnetic flux linked with the coil, EMF will be induced, and the induced EMF lasts or exists as long as there is change in magnetic flux. That is first law. The second law that gives the mathematical expression of the induced EMF. The induced EMF that is equal to minus d phi by dt. Negative rate of change in magnetic flux. According to Faraday's second law, the induced EMF developed across the coil, that E is equal to minus d phi by dt. Negative rate of change in magnetic flux linked with that coil. That negative sign is in accordance with Lenz law. According to that Lenz law, the direction of induced EMF is always in such a way that opposes the change in magnetic flux produced it. And with the increase in magnetic flux, suppose that EMF is induced, the direction of induced EMF that has to oppose that increase in magnetic flux. And if flux increase automatically, the EMF develop. Now the developed induced EMF is in such a way that has to oppose that increase in that flux. Suppose that EMF is induced due to the decrease in flux. That induced EMF, the direction of induced EMF is in such a way that has to oppose the change, that has to oppose the decrease in the magnetic flux. That is in accordance with Lenz law. That is important. Next. Suppose this is a circular coil. If north pole of the magnet that is moving towards the coil, due to the change in flux, EMF will be produced within that coil and an induced current flows through that coil. A current carrying circular coil that behaves like a magnetic dipole and that induced current that has to flow either in clockwise or in anti-clockwise direction. So depending upon the direction of motion of that magnet, suppose north pole of that magnet facing the plane of that coil, that is moving towards, as that is moving towards, the flux linked with the coil increases. The flux linked with the coil increases. Due to that increase in magnetic flux, that induced EMF produced in the coil, that has to oppose that increase in that flux. Ante ee magnet daggarku vastunte flux perugutundi. According to Lenz's law, the induced EMF that has to oppose that increase in flux, ante idi daggarku raakunda cheyali, ante this coil that has to repel that magnet. So plane of the coil that behaves like a north pole, mari idi north pole laga current act cheyalante that induced current that will be in anti-clockwise direction. That will be in the anti-clockwise direction. Now the coil that can be imagined as a cell, and that induced current flow that is within the cell. And ee it will through untadu kabatti. Mari within the cell, those that current flows from low potential to high potential. అంటే ఈ సర్క్యులర్ కాయిల్ మనం ఒక సెల్ లాగా ఇమాజిన్ చేసుకుంటే, ఇక్కడ టూ ప్లేట్స్ ఏ అండ్ బి, విత్ ఇన్ ద సెల్ దట్ ఇండ్యూస్ అ కరెంట్ దట్ ఫ్లోస్ ఫ్రమ్ లో పొటెన్షియల్ టు హై పొటెన్షియల్. ఇటు నుంచి వెళ్తూ ఉందంటే బి ఈజ్ ఆఫ్ నెగటివ్ పొటెన్షియల్, దీని మీదకి వస్తూ ఉంటే అది పాజిటివ్ పొటెన్షియల్గా కన్సిడర్ చేస్తాం. సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ the same magnet with the same north pole facing towards the coil, and that is moving away. As the magnet is moving away, flux linked with the coil decreases. According to Lenz's law, that has to oppose the decrease in that flux. And ee magnet away ga vellakunda cheyali ante the plane of the coil that behaves like a south pole due to that attraction that opposes the ఎవేయింగ్ మోషన్ ఆఫ్ దట్ మ్యాగ్నెట్. సో ఇది సౌత్ పోల్ లాగా యాక్ట్ చేస్తుంటుంది కాబట్టి నా సౌత్ పోల్ లాగా యాక్ట్ చేయాలి అంటే కరెంట్ దట్ షుడ్ బి ఇన్ క్లాక్ వైజ్ డైరెక్షన్, ఇలా యాక్ట్ చేస్తుంటుంది. అంటే ఇప్పుడు దీన్ని మనం ఒక సెల్గా తీసుకుంటే, మరి విత్ ఇన్ ద సెల్ అంటే కరెంట్ ఇలా వస్తుంది, ఇది ఇటు నుంచి వెళ్తుంది, ఇది ఏ ఇది బీ కాబట్టి now this is at low potential and this will be at high potential. అలాగే సౌత్ పోల్ పొలారిటీని రివర్స్ చేసినప్పుడు ఈ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ కూడా రివర్స్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి. నెక్స్ట్ దిస్ ఈస్ a metallic circular ring and this is a bar magnet north south. As that bar magnet that was dropped freely, as that magnet is approaching, the flux linked with that coil increases. According to Lenz's law, that has to oppose that increase in flux. So ఇది north pole laga act చేస్తూ ఉండాలి. So the current through that ring that will be in anti-clockwise direction. ఇది ఫ్రీగా ఫాలో అవుతుందంటే జీ యాక్సలరేషన్తో కిందకు వస్తుంది, బట్ డ్యూ టు దట్ రిపల్షన్ దట్ యాక్సలరేషన్ ఏ దట్ ఈస్ లెస్ దాన్ జీ అవుతుంది. నా యాజ్ దట్ రిసీవ్స్ ఇది దీంట్ నుంచి పాస్ అవుతూ బయటకు వచ్చేసింది, ఇది నార్త్ పోల్ ఇక్కడ సౌత్ పోల్. యాజ్ దట్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ అవే ఎవేగా వెళ్ళిపోతుంది కాబట్టి వన్స్ అగైన్ ద మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫ్లక్స్ లింక్డ్ విత్ ద కాయిల్ డిక్రీజెస్. అకార్డింగ్ టు లెంజ్ లా, ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు అపోజ్ ద డిక్రీజ్ ఇన్ ఫ్లక్స్ ద మ్యాగ్నెట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి అట్రాక్టెడ్ బై ద కాయిల్. మరి అట్రాక్ట్ చేయాలంటే వన్స్ అగైన్ దట్ హ్యాస్ టు యాక్ట్ యాజ్ నార్త్ పోల్. వన్స్ అగైన్ ద కరెంట్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ యాంటీ క్లాక్ వైజ్ డైరెక్షన్. मरी इध फ्री फाक पैक अट्राक्टे वन अगेन दीज ली अजी सपोज स्मॉल कट और स्मॉल गैप इज मेड विथिन दट सर्क्युलर रिंग एंड दट मैग्नेट इज अलाउड टू पास पास नाउ द इंड्यूस्ड करंट इज इक्वल टू जीरो that induced current that flows only through the closed loop epudaithe ikkada cut gap create chesamo induced current I induced that is equal to zero still there exists an induced emf there exists here that magnet that falls with an acceleration A is equal to G. Next. This is a circular coil placed just above the long stride conductor. When constant current flows through that conductor, now what will be the induced current? I, that is constant. When constant current flows through the conductor, due to the current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. And above E point, the magnetic induction B produces only, which is perpendicular to the plane, radiate from the plane. अरे आलरे मैं एलक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिज्म पे చెప్పుకున్నా ఇక్కడ కరెంట్ ఈ డైరెక్షన్ ఫ్లో అవుతుంటే మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఇండక్షన్ ఇదేగా ఉంటుంది దట్ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఇండక్షన్ B ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు మ్యూ నాట్ I బై 2 పై r డ్యూ టు ఏ లాంగ్ స్ట్రైట్ కండక్టర్ యాస్ ద కాన్స్టెంట్ కరెంట్ ఫ్లోస్ దట్ B రిమైన్స్ కాన్స్టెంట్ సో ఫ్లక్స్ దట్ రిమైన్స్ కాన్స్టెంట్ So induced EMF that is equal to minus d phi by dt that is equal to zero. Okay? So induced EMF or induced current is equal to zero. Epudu when constant current flows through that long stride conductor. Next, when current through that conductor is increasing, I that is increasing. As I increases, that outward magnetic flux, that is perpendicular to the plane, deviate from the plane, that also increases. So, as that current through that conductor is increasing, outward magnetic flux increases. According to Lenz's law, that induced current or induced EMF. That has to oppose that increase and output flux perugutu undi ante karakunda cheyali ante you have to produce some inward flux develop cheyali ante the current should flow through the coil in the clockwise direction so bi induced magnetic field that should be perpendicular to the plane into the plane My perpendicular to the plane into the plane undaliyante current through that will be clockwise direction now current is flowing from left to right which is decreasing I decrease outward ante that B naught which is perpendicular to the plane away from the plane outward flux is decreasing outward flux perugutund ante according to Lenz's law that has to oppose decreasing and outward flux ni avoid cheyalante you have to supply some additional outward flux so that induced magnetic field that should also be in the direction perpendicular to the plane away from the plane andukane outward flux ni induce cheyali ante current through the coil that will be in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, follow? And constant current flows, B remains constant, A constant, change in flux is zero. Now, so VI that is equal to zero. Now, current through the conduct is increasing. Current through the conduct is increasing. So, outward flux increases. According to Lenz's law, that has to oppose. Outward flux increase of oriented, inducer flux that will be into the plane of bearing. And that should act as a south pole, and the current through that is a clockwise direction. And the current decreases out only. Outward flux decreases. According to Lenz's law, we have to oppose that decrease in outward flux. So, some more outward flux is to be inducer. So, inducer magnet flux also outward direction. Outward oriented current that should be an anti-clockwise direction. Next. Suppose electron an electron that is moving from left to right. Now, the convectional flow of current, I, it will be something. Now, as an electron and as the current, it will pass through the day. Flux linked with the coil increases. And a flux linked with the coil and a that BO that will be perpendicular to the plane into the plane. Into that plane into the and the inward flux increase avutunte according to Lenz's law inward flux ni oppose cheyalante kontha outward flux produce cheyali. So BI that should be perpendicular to the plane away from the plane. So the induced current I induce first in anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise eppudu when an electron approaches and the current it will pass. When an electron is receding, away ga velthunte inward flux ade away ga velipothunte inward flux decrease avutundi. Inward flux decrease avukunda undali ante inducer flux also should be inwards. So inducer when an electron approaching appudu inducer current is an anti clockwise. I induce when an electron receives ante dooram velipothundi. Dooram velipothunte em avutundi once again idi tagipothundi ante inward flux tagguthu undali. Tagakunda cheyalante additional ga manaki inwards kavali. Inwards kavali ante now clockwise. So as an electron that is moving from left to right and a circular coil placed just above the conductor, as an electron approaches the coil, so induced current that will be anti-clockwise. When that electron receives the coil, appudu that induced current that will be in clockwise direction. ఇక్కడ మనకి ఇవన్నీ థియరిటికల్ బిట్స్ గా కన్సిడర్ చేస్తాం. నెక్స్ట్ మరి అకార్డింగ్ టు ఫారడే సెకండ్ లా ఈ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు మైనస్ డి ఫై బై డిటి మైనస్ డి బై డిటి ఆఫ్ NAB into cos theta. In order to change in flux, ఇక్కడ మొత్తం నాలుగు పారామీటర్స్ ఉన్నాయి. నాలుగిట్లో ఏది చేంజ్ అయినా సరే మనకి ఫ్లక్స్ చేంజ్ అవుతుంది, EMF డెవలప్ అవుతూ ఉంటుంది. ఇక్కడ మనకి ఈ యావరేజ్ కావాలి అంటే Suppose area of the coil is changing and the other parameters remains constant. NB cos theta into A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1 by T2 minus T1. Okay. Eppudu when A is changing. Adi E instantaneous sign appudu. That is nothing but NB cos theta into dA by dt. NB cos theta into dA by dt. Suppose area that is decreasing. Suppose a circular coil is kunte, a circular coil area d by dt of pi r square అప్పుడు ఏమొస్తుంది ఎన్ బి కాస్ థీటా ఇంటూ పై ఇంటూ టూ ఆర్ ఇంటూ డిఆర్ బై డిటి ఇన్స్టంటేనియస్ ఈఎంఎఫ్ అండ్ ద రేడియస్ ఈస్ షింకింగ్ ఎట్ ద రేట్ డిఆర్ బై డిటి ఎట్ ద ఇన్స్టంట్ ద రేడియస్ రేడియస్ ఎట్ దట్ ఇన్స్టంట్ ఇస్తారు and radius is shrinking at the rate and star dr by dt formula idokati important when the radius of that circular coil is shrinking now the instantaneous emf at that instant radius of that coil is r and the shrinking rate is dr by dt and star ala deentlo prati term change avutu undochu. Suppose NAB remains constant and the coil is rotating. Now that average this quote NAB into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2 by T2 minus T1. Again ikkada minus reverse avutundi kabatti. Adi e instantaneous koche vaadiki NAB into d by dt of cos theta is nothing but omega t. Appudu e instantaneous d by dt of cos omega t ante minus omega into sin omega t. N a b omega into sin omega t form avutundi. Now that maximum induced EMF that is equal to NAB into omega. NAB into omega. So that E instantaneous that is equal to E naught sine omega t. Sinusoidal variation of that. Next. The induced current I induced that is equal to E induced by R. I is equal to E by R, V by R by the formula. Induced EMF by resistance of the coil. Now, induced charge I is nothing but dQ by dt, which is equal to E is equal to minus d phi by dt 1 by r into minus r. From that dq that is equal to minus d phi by r. So both sides integrate chesthe integral dq is nothing but q that is equal to 1 by r integral d phi into phi kabati phi 1 minus phi 2. So that is nothing but delta phi by r. That is the induced charge. Whereas that induced EMF and induced current depends upon time in which that change in flux takes place. induced current or induced EMF that depends upon the time in which that flux is changing, but that induced charge that is independent of time in which that flux is changing, which is equal to change in flux by R, d phi by R, that itself, that is the induced charge. Now, next, there is uniform magnetic field of induction in a internal vector now, B is perpendicular to the plane into the plane. There are two parallel horizontal conductors. Now, this is a conductor of its length L. L is the length of the conductor, which is moving perpendicular to its length with velocity V, due to which there will be change in flux linked with that loop. And in the work, manaku oka loop laga untundi kabatti ee conductor V velocity to move avutunte B constant, but V velocity to conductor move avutunte area of that loop is changing. So that induced EMF E is equal to BLV. Induced EMF is equal to BLV, which is equal to in vector form L bar dot V bar cross B bar. L bar dot V bar cross B bar. That is the induced EMF. Ikkada L, length of the conductor vector, B vector, velocity vector. There are mood vectors in chi, but man EMF and scalar travel cavity, that is L bar dot B bar cross B bar. As these three are mutually perpendicular, B bar cross B bar lies perpendicular to the plane, both V bar and B bar, that will become parallel to L bar. So dot product of two vectors represents a scalar. Actual ga V bar cross B bar, that is equal to VB sin theta, that is equal to BLV sin theta. Where theta is angle between that B bar and V bar. B bar, V bar, majorana angle theta, that induced EMF E is equal to BLV sin theta. That is the induced EMF development across the length of the conductor. Marie, across that length of that conductor, the direction of induced current, that is determined by using Fleming's right hand rule. Fleming's right hand rule. Mari mana electromagnetism chapter lo the force experienced by that current carrying conductor or force experienced by that moving charge. అప్పుడు మనమంతా కూడా ఫ్లెమింగ్స్ లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ రూల్ అప్లై చేసాం. చాప్టర్ వైజ్గా గుర్తుపెట్టుకోండి, ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నిజం అంతా కూడా ఫోర్స్ టు డిటర్మిన్ ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఫోర్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అప్లై ఫ్లెమింగ్స్ లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ రూల్. మరి ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిక్ ఇండక్షన్లో ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఇండ్యూస్డ్ కరెంట్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయాలంటే యూ హ్యావ్ టు అప్లై ఫ్లెమింగ్స్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్ రూల్. స్ట్రెచ్ ద ఫస్ట్ త్రీ ఫింగర్స్ ఆఫ్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్. ఓకే, మరి లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ అయినా రైట్ హ్యాండ్ అయినా ఫోర్ ఫింగర్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ దట్ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫీల్డ్. హియర్ థంబ్, అక్కడ ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిజంలో అయితే ఫోర్స్ని రిప్రజెంట్ చేస్తుంది, ఈ ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిక్ ఇండక్షన్లో థంబ్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మోషన్ ఆఫ్ ద కండక్టర్. థంబ్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మోషన్ ఆఫ్ ద కండక్టర్. వెరాస్ సెంట్రల్ ఫింగర్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఇండ్యూస్డ్ కరెంట్. మరి ఆ కండక్టర్ని మనం విత్ ఇన్ ద సెల్ లాగా తీసుకుంటాం కాబట్టి ఇండ్యూస్డ్ కరెంట్ దట్ ఫ్లోస్ ఫ్రమ్ లో పొటెన్షియల్ టు హై పొటెన్షియల్, అంటే ఇక్కడ మనం పిక్యూ అనే పాయింట్స్ని కన్సిడర్ చేస్తే, మరి దీని వరకు మనం ఒక సెల్ లాగా తీసుకుంటే, నౌ ద ఇండ్యూస్డ్ కరెంట్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ఫ్లెమింగ్స్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్ రూల్, బి ఈజ్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ ద ప్లేన్, థంబ్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మోషన్ ఆఫ్ ద కండక్టర్, సో ఇండ్యూస్డ్ కరెంట్ ఫ్లోస్ ఫ్రమ్ క్యూ టు పి. that will be the direction of induced current. I induce, which is from low potential to high potential. Kabatti Q is negative and P is positive. మరి ఇక్కడ మనం ఒక కెపాసిటర్ని ప్లేస్ చేస్తే మరి ఇదేమో పాజిటివ్ ప్లేట్గా యాక్ట్ చేస్తుంది, ఇదేమో నెగటివ్ ప్లేట్గా యాక్ట్ చేస్తుంటుంది. నౌ ద అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఛార్జ్ దట్ వాజ్ డిపాజిటెడ్ ఆన్ దీస్ టూ ప్లేట్స్, ఇది ఏ బి ప్లేట్స్గా తీసుకుంటే, ద అపాన్ ద ప్లేట్ ఏ పాజిటివ్ ఛార్జ్, upon plate B negative charge. You know that Q is equal to CV kabatti C into V potential difference. And potential capacitor ee conductor ki parallel ga undi kabatti now that induced charge QA that will be C into that induced EMF. Induced EMF that will be positive. Whereas QB, that is C into induced EMF, that will be negative. Magnetic field, that is perpendicular to the plane into the plane. This is the length of the conductor L, which moves with velocity v. ante ee magnetic field b tho adi v velocity chestu move avutundi anukunte, that is nothing but itu vaipu v cos theta aithe itu vaipu b sin theta ga avutundi. Ikkada angle theta iskunte idi velocity v, appudu ee direction lo v cos theta, ee direction lo v sin theta. మరి కాంపోనెంట్ ఆఫ్ వెలాసిటీ దట్ విల్ బి పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు దట్ ఉండాలి కాబట్టి ఇండ్యూస్డ్ ఈఎంఎఫ్ దట్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు బిఎల్వి సైన్ తీటా. నెక్స్ట్ దిస్ ఈస్ ఎ లాంగ్ స్ట్రైట్ కండక్టర్ ఆఫ్ టోటల్ లెంగ్త్ ఎల్ అంటే బెంట్ అట్ ఇట్స్ మిడ్ పాయింట్ కాబట్టి ఇది ఎల్ బై టూ, ఇది ఎల్ బై టూ. ఇది మొత్తం తీటా అయితే ఇది తీటా బై టూ, ఇది తీటా బై టూ. ఎఫెక్టివ్ లెంగ్త్ అంటే ఇది ఇది ఎక్స్, ఇది ఎక్స్ అయితే ఎల్ ఎఫెక్టివ్ దట్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు టూ ఎక్స్, టూ ఇంటూ L by 2 into sin theta by 2, which is equal to L sin theta by 2. So, మరి ఇది ఇటువైపు V velocity మూవ్ అవుతుంటే దట్ ఇండ్యూస్డ్ EMF దట్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు V L V sin theta by 2. Next, this is a long straight conductor carrying current I. This is a conductor. మరి ఇక్కడి నుంచి ఎంతవరకు ఏగా తీసుకుందాం, ఇక్కడి నుంచి ఎంతవరకు బీగా తీసుకుందాం. This is moving with the velocity v ga iskunte. Now the induced EMF developed across the length of the conductor. Mari ee mottham length of the current conductor ni manam chinna chinna parts ga iskundam. Dx ga iskunte ikkadi chikkada daaka unna distance x anukunte. Mari due to this small current element, that small induced EMF developed d is equal to nothing but B dx into V. But due to this long straight conductor carrying current, magnetic induction at a distance B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi into x. So that is mu naught I B by 2 pi into 1 by x into dx. B value you can substitute chadha, D. Now the total induced EMF developed across the ends of the conductor, the total EMF ante ante ee dx anedi b nunchi ikkada daaka vary avutundi kabatti, so that is mu naught iv by 2 pi integral 1 by x dx limits b nunchi b plus a daaka untundi ante starting point idaithe ending point ee mottham ante b plus a avutundi. Integral 1 by x dx ante log x to the base e. And limits apply chesthe that induced EMF mu naught I V by 2 pi into log B plus A by B to the base E. That will be the induced EMF developed across the length of the conductor. Important model. Next, this is a long conductor carrying current I, and this is a square loop of side A which is moving with the velocity v. And the distance of the center of the square from the conductor is r, the distance a. Here that r that is very much greater than that of a. So due to the motion of the square loop, you have to find the induced EMF developed inside the closed loop square. As you know, flux phi that is equal to b dot a, but b is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi r, a is nothing but a square. Now the induced EMF developed that E is equal to d phi by dt. So mu naught I a square by 2 pi d by dt of 1 by r, actually the minus kada d by dt of 1 by r ante minus 1 by r square into dr by dt. Appudu minus minus cancel avutundi. So d by dt of 1 by r ante minus 1 by r square into dr by dt. Minus minus cancel avutundi kabatti mu naught I a square by 2 pi into 1 by r square into dr by dt. Dr by dt is nothing but velocity v kabatti. So that induced EMF mu naught I by 2 pi into a square by r square into v. In that case lo, this is a horizontal conductor, it is a long current carrying conductor, and that moves perpendicular to its length. Induced EMF across that in that direction. Now this is a square loop of side A that is moving with velocity v, which is at a distance r from the long stride conductor carrying current. Due to the motion of that conductor, induced EMF developed calculation. As flux length of the coil B dot A, and if r very much greater than A kabatti, idi A by 2 neglect chestam. So B place lo mu naught I by 2 pi r into area ante A square. So dani simplify chesthe induced EMF mu naught I by 2 pi into a square by r square into v. Next, one more example. These are two separate coils of radii r and 2r moving with the velocities 2v and v. The upper ends A and B on a conducting surface where there is uniform magnetic field perpendicular to the plane and strength of that magnetic field is B. And ippudu deenni manam ila consider cheyachu. For this, length of the conductor is nothing but 2r that is moving with the velocity v. This is the length of the conductor 4r and that is moving with velocity v. Idi point A, idi point B. Idi conducting surface anukundam. There that magnetic field is perpendicular to the plane into the plane. So that induced EMF across that first conductor, it will be into the plane and that conductor is moving towards left cavity, induced current flows from A to the common point O ga iskunte. Deen varaku within the cell laga iskunte, induced current flows from low potential to high potential. Ante idi low potential and this plate becomes a high potential. అంటే ఈ కండక్టర్ మనం ఒక సెల్లులాగా తీసుకుంటే మరి అక్రాస్ దట్ ఇండ్యూస్డ్ ఈఎంఎఫ్ ఈ1గా తీసుకుందాం. మరి ఈ కేసుకు రండి. బి ఈస్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ద ప్లేన్ అండ్ ద కండక్టర్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ టువర్డ్స్ రైట్ అండ్ ఇండ్యూస్డ్ ఈఎంఎఫ్ ఆర్ ఇండ్యూస్డ్ కరెంట్ ఫ్లోస్ ఫ్రమ్ బాటమ్ టు టాప్. అంటే ఇది లో పొటెన్షియల్, ఇది హై పొటెన్షియల్ అవుతుంది. ఇది బి అవుతుంది. Induced EMF formula BLV kada, that is equal to B. L is nothing but 2R into V. Ikkada E2, E same D, but length is 4R and velocity is V. And conducting surface level. If positive terminal of one of the cell is connected to negative terminal of the cell, these two cells are connected in series and they are supporting. So equivalent EMF across AB that is equal to E1 plus E2 which is equal to 2R into 2V kada. It is 2V velocity. So that is equal to 8BRV. Next. Rotational EMF. Due to the rotation of the conductor, this is a conductor of length L which is fixed at point O and the free end is rotated either in clockwise or in anti-clockwise which cuts the magnetic flux. Magnetic lines of force and cut chestu unnapudu induced EMF will be developed across the ends. Idi OA. O is the fixed point ga isthunte. This is the free end of that rotation. That O is always fixed end of that rotation is always at higher potential, say positive potential. The free end of rotation is at lower potential, that will be negative. That induced EMF developed across the ends of that conductor E that is equal to half B L square omega as that is rotating with an angular velocity omega. E is equal to half B L square omega. Now the induced current I induced that is equal to half B L square omega by R. I is nothing but E by R kada. Now, the magnetic force experienced by that current carrying conductor, ఇప్పుడు దీంట్లోంచి కరెంట్ ఫ్లో అవుతుంది. దట్ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫోర్స్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్డ్ దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ బిఐఎల్ కదా ఫార్ములా. I induced into L. Suppose if that conductor is rotated about its midpoint, ఇది O అనుకుందాం, ఇది A, ఇది B అనుకుంటే, total length L అయితే ఇది L by 2, ఇది L by 2. Fixed end of rotation is always at higher potential, ఇది positive అయితే, ఇది negative అవుతుంది. Induced EMF across OA, that is nothing but EO minus EA, that is nothing but half B, L square by 4 into omega. So that is nothing but B L square omega by 8. E across OB, that is equal to EO minus EB. Once again, B L square omega by 8 outumi. Induced EMF across AB. అంటే దీనికి నుంచి దీన్ని సబ్ట్రాక్ట్ చేసాం అనుకోండి, ఈ రెండు క్యాన్సిల్ అవుతుంది. ఇఫ్ దట్ రాడ్ ఈజ్ రొటేటెడ్ అబౌట్ ఇట్స్ మిడ్ పాయింట్, ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ మిడ్ పాయింట్, ఇండ్యూస్డ్ ఈఎంఎఫ్ అక్రాస్ ద టూ ఫ్రీ ఎండ్స్ ఆఫ్ దట్ రొటేషన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో అవుతుంది. This is the conductor of resistance R1, resistance R2. This is a conductor of length L, metallic conductor whose resistance is negligible, and that is moving with velocity V perpendicular to the plane into the plane. Now that induced EMF, E induced, that is equal to BLV, whereas induced current, that is nothing but E induced by R effective. As these two are in parallel, that is equal to BLV, R effective ante R1 plus R2 by R1 R2 avutundi. Suppose if R is the resistance of the conductor which is moving, appudu I induced, that is equal to BLV by, mundu ee rendu okadankoti parallel, aa tarvata deeniki idi series avutundi kabatti R plus R1 R2 by R1 plus R2, which is equal to BLV into R1 plus R2 by R1 R2 plus R into R1 plus R2. This is a conductor. This is moving with velocity V. దీని రెసిస్టెన్స్ వరకు R అనుకుందాం. Magnetic field perpendicular to the plane into the plane. Now that induced current, that is equal to BLV by R. Now that force experience of that moving conductor placed in uniform magnetic field, that is nothing but B I induced into L V. I induced is nothing but BL V by R into L, which is equal to B square L square V by R. That is the magnetic force experienced by this current carrying conductor placed in uniform magnetic field. Ikkada within the uniform magnetic field lo L length of the conductor B velocity tho movutunte ee deentlo nunchi inducer current flow avutundi. Inducer current I induce redirection undi. So this current carrying conductor placed in uniform magnetic field that experiences a magnetic force B square L square V by R. Now the power required to move with that constant velocity, power, that is nothing but Fm dot V, that is equal to V square L square V square by R. That is the power. Okay. Next. Finally, one more application. When the magnetic field that varies with the time and with respect to distance also, E is equal to d phi by dt. A negative sign anedi in accordance with Lenz law ante. Mari phi is equal to p bar dot a bar ga iskunte a into dv by dt. E induced emf due to time varying magnetic field. B varies with time aithe, suppose that B varies with the distance also. Now that E is equal to A into dB by dx into dx by dt ga iskunte, but dx by dt is nothing but velocity v kabatti A v into dB by dx. So total induced EMF when that B varies with the time and also with the distance ainappudu, A common isthe, that is nothing but dB by dt plus V into dB by dx. The total induced EMF developed in a coil of area A where that intensity of magnetic field B varies with the time and also with the distance. D varies with the distance. Ante A into dV by dt ni ila convert cheddam. But dx by dt is nothing but velocity. AV into dV by dx. So total induced EMF developed A into dV by dt plus V into dV by dx. మరి ఈ ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిక్ ఇండక్షన్ మనకి నెక్స్ట్ మండే వస్తుంది. మళ్ళీ దాంట్లో ఇంకా రిమైనింగ్ పార్ట్ దట్ ఈస్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇండక్షన్, మ్యూచువల్ ఇండక్షన్, అలాగే ఎనర్జీ స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ ఎన్ ఇండక్టర్, కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఇండక్టర్స్, దట్ వీ విల్ డిస్కస్ ఆన్ మండే. ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ.